bitch, whore, sure, all good examples. That doesn't really cover it. Sorry about the lighting, but in order for me to continue to work, it's important that no one sees who I am. Jail? No thanks. Orange jumpsuits aren't my style. Same goes for the glasses. I want to be able to continue to provide my services. It's an intoxicating thing, knowing someone is going to die when their fate is in your hands. It's hard to even think of them as meat. I know that is thrown around often enough, but actually I'm quite fond of a nice steak. This is close to pure obscenity. It's a natural order, really. The sick and weak must die for the others to flourish. Oh, definitely. Sick and weak. Weak of mind. Depraved. I definitely prefer to work days. The nights put people on guard. I couldn't work out in the open at night. In a location like a bar, forget about it. After a few days, you start to recognize some familiar faces. The blonde ones are particularly dim. Definite attention whores. Some are just so brazen. It's sickening, really. Patience is, as they say, a virtue. Familiarity causes someone to drop their guard. Oh, definitely. I feel I'm providing a service. I want to better the world. Again, a service worth providing. There's something about blood on a white surface. Slaughtered lamb. Blood on snow, even blood on your bathroom sink. Mesmerizing. They aren't the most successful advertising colors on accident. It's primal. Once you identify the job, or the victim if you prefer, then there are details to iron out. Where, when, how. I still say open spaces work best. People are so focused on not focusing on people, you can get away with murder. Literally.
Perfect. You transcribed that beautifully. How do you feel about my service now? Bettering the world one piece of trash at a time. Hey, what are you doing after this?